Coke Talk is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. And down he goes at the 29. The Ducks and their ground game's always been sensational. It's not always one guy, Herbie. Sometimes they've got two or three that can carry the load.
And that's what makes it so tough for this defense, is you're not focusing in on just one guy. You're focusing in on really an entire scheme. And because of that diversity, I think it makes it more of a challenge. And you got to be better tacklers in the open field. And I think that's really what they've stressed all week, is tackling and gang tackling and getting to the football.
Hard to get to guys and make tackles in space. A two-yard run by the halfback.
And that was the junior corner who'll get credit with that tackle.
He's scrambling. And they make the stop at the 41-yard line. And he has a huge gain.
And I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks. He sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him. And he takes off. Ends up with a great run.
Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
Number 16, the intended receiver on the play.
From their own 41-yard line. Second down. They'll run it. And down he goes at the 50-yard line. Here's an opening. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. From the 49-yard line, first down. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. Pressured and brought down.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out at practice, they told us there were some big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against him, maybe get the ball out of the pocket a little bit quicker, maybe use running backs and tight ends to help with double teams on the outside. But right now, whatever they thought they might be able to do, they better get back to that drawing board, because these defensive ends are just too quick.
Fires that quickly, incomplete. And now they're faced with another third and long as they try to convert and move those chains again. And he's going to come up with a sack.
That makes it third and long.
Fourth and long here after the sack. It looks like they're going to go after this punt. He's to the 40. He's got the corner. To the 10. And they're going to bring this one all the way back. Touchdown! Ducks quarterback, we saw him taken out earlier down there on the sideline after being injured. I don't think he's in that much pain right now, though, and I would bet that he'll be back in the game before today's done. He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Fakes to the back. Passes, and it's almost picked off.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception, only to be dropped.
From their own 30-yard line, it's second down. he's pushed out of bounds. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
He scrambled. Brought down at the 39. Makes the tackle. That's a gain of 8 on the play. That'll bring up second and 3. There he goes. Good outside run there.
Yeah, I love this offensive coordinator. I've always really appreciated his approach to the game. He's a little bit unorthodox in his approach, and this time he gives the wide receiver a chance to carry the football to pick up a first down.
Now he's scrambling. Tackle at the 25-yard line.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
Out to the tailback, and he dropped it. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
That makes it 2nd and 10.
He's into the open field. Touchdown, Oregon. What a spectacular run by the quarterback.
That is such a weapon for your offense when you have a quarterback who can do things like that. The coach probably loves drawing up plays for this guy.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's got the corner. Tackle made at the 34-yard line. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete. From their own 34-yard line, second down, the quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Wide open. Oh, he dropped it. Well, we've got a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche? Come out in a 5-wide set. Quick out to his receiver. And he shoved out of bounds around the 49-yard line.
Nice throw to hit the out route against man coverage for a first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 49. At the 40. Got some open field. The 10. Touchdown. Big play.
Wow. When you see that end zone in front of you, it can elevate your running to another level. Awesome play.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. A 4-play, 66-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. kick this one away. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He's taken down at the 29-yard line.
That's good for 83 yards. That'll make it 77.
He tries to buy some time, and he's tackled at the 33.
Good coverage by the defense, but they have to be aware of this quarterback's tendency to scramble around and pick up some yards.
On the pitch, look out, loose ball, recovered by the defense.
That's a tough break, but he's going to get another chance today. What I want to see is if he'll change his running style after losing the ball like this.
It looks like there's an injury down there on the field. Well, they had a lot of success on their last possession, and now they're going to start this one off with excellent field position.
It's hard to ask your defense to come out and make a stop when they're already backed up this far within their own end zone.
He gets hit out of bounds at the 12. From the 12-yard line, first down. Touchdown. And once again, he finds the end zone. That's his second rushing touchdown of the game.
This guy has great vision out of the backfield. Even if a hole isn't there, he's patient enough to wait for one to open, and then he hits it.
And he hits the PAT. A quick two-play, 31-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's tackled at the 26. The offense comes out of the field, and they're hoping to avoid the similar fate that killed their last drive.
The game is in danger of getting out of hand early. It's very, very important that they not only hang on to the football this drive, but they also need to get a score on the board as well.
First quarter is over. Watch out, folks. This one is turning into a major upset. 21-7. To the action now here in the second quarter. The Ducks had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. Third and about 13 yards. Ball on the 23. The throw, incomplete pass.
He threw that ball so hard, I don't think anybody wanted to catch it.
And they push him out at about the 39-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Hands it to the back. They'll bring him down at the 38.
That's a deep play. That brings up second and 9.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. Yeah. he's tackled at about the 21. From the 21-yard line, it's first down.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
Slings it right. Incomplete pass.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
He heaves it to the end zone. And it's picked off. It's the safety.
There you go. If you're going to come back in this game, it's going to start with one play. And maybe that pick is what turns things around for you.
First and 10. Ball on their own 20. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Complete. He's got space to work. Tackle made around the 29-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Makes it to the 37. He has some room. Tackled after a decent pickup.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
And he's taken down at the 46-yard line. The middle for a nice game.
That makes it first and 10.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Got hit and still completed it. He's knocked out of bounds right around the 36-yard line. With a quick throw, and it falls incomplete. Boy, would he like to have that one back.
Yeah, you're right. This offense relies so much on timing, and as you saw there, when their timing gets knocked off, they have a tough time connecting on plays like this.
Hand off inside, and he's quickly brought down. The sophomore that's got it. And they had a tough time defending that one.
with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable in one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
And he converts the extra point. Oregon gets set to kick this one away. He'll take it from the two. They'll bring him down at the 29. An interception cut this offense last drive short, so I think they're going to be looking for a little more success right here.
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out. I wouldn't be surprised if they kept up the pressure to try to fluster this quarterback some more.
Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he hits him hard at the 39-yard line. Gets it. He's in space. He goes out of bounds at the 44-yard line. It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. He's got it with room to run. Very clutch tackle there because this kid had some space. The offense calls a timeout. Throws it in a hurry. And he's in the end zone. Touchdown. And he tacks on the extra point. Like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. A touchdown was the end result of their last drive as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack the defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job of being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback put the ball right on the money.
So the sack makes this a second and long. He's on the run, runs with it, and he's got room. Slides down to the ground. First half is over, and this is why they play the game. 28-14.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. When we come to the studio, I like to give you a peek behind the curtain. I don't want to just give you scores and highlights and analysis. I want to let you know what happens in here.
Pull it back, brother.
You know how good these offenses were in the first half.
How good were these offenses?
So good. You were loving it. You have this big persona, big tough defensive guy. You were loving that offensive performance.
I don't know what you're talking about. I went to the snack room about 5 minutes into this game.
Not true.
It is fun. You do appreciate good offense. I mean, sometimes it's really bad defense, and then sometimes you see the designs of plays and the offensive coordinator dialing up perfect time to go long. Think about it. You get a few good positive runs. Everybody starts to commit. You take shots down the field. Sometimes the offenses do dial up great plays. Sometimes the defenses afford them that opportunity by dialing up bad plays. Right now, the OCs are on point.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready with a call.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. It's fielded at the 2. Across the 30. And he's tackled at the 33-yard line. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. And he just gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. Brought down at the 44. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44. After the running back, no good.
He came so close to getting his feet in. And I'll tell you, for a running back, that's a tough catch to pull in when you're not used to making sideline catches.
And they make the stop right around the 46-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Quick throw out to the receiver. And down he goes at about the 29-yard line. Down, 10 to go. Ball on the 29. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. That's good for a gain of 5 yards. This is the 8th play of this drive. Pushed out of bounds, right around the 20. Short yardage situation here. It's 3rd and 1. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line.
That was some sure tackling to make sure he didn't pick up the first down.
Big play there, and now they're looking at 1st and goal. First down, and they'll bring it up 1st and goal inside the 5. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Strike to the receiver, touchdown. He flicked his wrist and made the connection to his wide receiver.
It looked to me that the defense was more worried about the quarterback scrambling, and that's why they just gave up that touchdown.
He makes the PAT. picks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
He gets out to about the 44-yard line. He's taken down around the 46-yard line. At the
49.
It's broken up. He threw that to a guy who was well covered, and it almost got intercepted.
Yeah, he's very lucky that ball was only tipped.
Taken down at the 46.
Huge play for the defense.
They're ready to start another drive, hoping to duplicate the results of the last one, which ended in a touchdown.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
From the 45-yard line, 2nd down. Complete. He's got room. Tackle at the 36. Brought down in the open field. It's 2nd down, and they're about the length of the football from the 1st down marker. They'll bring him down around the 25-yard line. Inside the 10. There's another. Making a triple dip, folks.
If I were the head coach of this football team, I would give him the ball at least 30 times a game.
And he hits the PAT. A 5-play, 46-yard drive. And they put up 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Ducks have just gone ice cold on offense. They can't seem to get anything going.
Right now, they just have to forget the score, forget the clock, just go out there and try to get a first down, try to hope to build a little bit more confidence and continuity on this offense.
Got it, and brought down immediately. He's going to try and scramble. He's to the 40. It's a fumble. The defense has it.
He's tackled.
At about the 47-yard line.
They work hard, and they got the turnover.
Well, this is what it's all about. Defense taking advantage of an opportunity. They're pouncing on the loose ball.
One quarter to go before they turn the college football world upside down. 42-14.
Well, folks, we resume action here in the fourth quarter. We'll hope for some action because so far it's been a lopsided one. The offense was able to punch it in the end zone on that last drive. They'll come back out looking for more of the same.
They just seem like they've been in the end zone time and time again. There's not much negative you can say about this performance.
That brings up second and nine.
From the 47-yard line, second down. He's scrambling, and he's sacked.
He has one job on passing situations, get to the quarterback, and he did that job very, very well on that play.
It's third down and 14 yards to go now after that setback by the sack. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. He rifles it to the left. Almost picked off.
Number 80, the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
And he gets just a little on the return.
That time the coverage was all over.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries.
Scrambling around. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Tackle made
right around the 24-yard line.
Flips it middle to the running back, and he's taken down at the 22-yard line.
That'll bring up second and 12.
So it's second and 12. Ball on the 22-yard line. Nearly picked off, but he couldn't hold it.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
Mike four.
Looks to his back, and he's got him again. Brought down at the 26. Makes the catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
Midfield, brought down at the 49-yard line. Nice yardage on the run back. Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
Second down and six. Ball on the 46. Just under three to go in regulation. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
When you've got the experience that this safety has, you can read plays very quickly and be in just the right position to make a stop near the line of scrimmage.
gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And they make the stop at the 38-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 38. On the ground, right side. He fights forward to about the 36.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Gets to about the 34-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 28. Oregon staff and really this entire team, I'm sure, is going to rally around this kid.
Yeah, it's a tough loss for this team. I mean, they put so much into this game. But one thing about them is they're a team. And even though their star player had a tough game, I think they'll pick him back up and get him ready to go by next week.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.